campaign season. We talked a lot about unconventional candidates, but I'm about to talk about, no, not Bernie Sanders and not Donald Trump, 25-year-old Erin Schrode. She is running for Congress in her hometown of Marin County in California's 2nd District. If she wins, she would be the youngest woman ever elected to Congress, the first woman younger than 30.
I am running because I believe it's time to deliver on the promise of my generation. And my peers are revolutionizing every vertical. Yet politics remains left in the dark.
She is joining me here, Erin Schrode. Nice to have you back on the show.
A pleasure.
You were sitting in that same seat when you had just gone over to Greece after watching the crisis with the refugees. Just a little bit about this young woman. When you were 13, you started the environmental nonprofit Turning Green. 18, after the earthquake happened in Haiti, you went to Haiti to help. And now at 24, you launched a congressional campaign. First of all, I'm feeling like a wicked underachiever looking back at my 24 and 25 years. Secondly, I mean, with all due respect, how the heck do you think you're going to pull this off?
I think this is the time. We are seeing the political cycle this time around being welcoming of outsiders, tapping into that energy around disenfranchised, ignored, excluded. And we've seen such resonance in our messaging around representative democracy, a voice that is entirely unrepresented right now at the national level.
What is your day like, day to day on the campaign?
It's wild. It's a lot of boots on the ground up and down the district. We stretch from the Golden Gate to the Oregon border. It's enormous, a third of the California coast. And I love getting to meet people, to engage and talk about the issues that matter, delve into policy, and come up with common solutions for the common good.
You have just turned 25, so
yes.
Happy belated, and
that
makes you official to be able to do this. Let's talk about your who you're running against, an incumbent, Congressman Jared Huffman, who has outraised and outspent you by hundreds of thousands of dollars. He's represented the North Bay area for 6 years in the California Assembly before being elected to Congress in 2012.
Mm-hmm.
He says he has a record that is 100% pro-choice, 100% pro-equality. He's worked on countless measures, affordable housing, protecting ranches, you know, water reform. Why do you think you could beat someone who has many more years under his belt?
I fundamentally believe that progressive female voices result in better policy and that young people are uniquely equipped to lead the future of our state. Talk about learning and the future of work, education, and jobs, right? I graduated from college less than 3 years ago, feeling the burdens of student debt, knowing what it's like to enter the job landscape without the relevant or necessary skills training, and thinking about who is architecting the industries of the future. It's my peers who are using that innovative spirit to revolutionize science and media and tech, bringing that into government and paying attention to investment now rather than paying the price for spiking employment.
We're talking about how, I mean, it's outstanding. You're 25. This is a goal of yours. You've also talked about how you're running against two middle-aged men. Your words, is it fair to target age?
I do believe that that is something that makes me uniquely equipped to lead right now. I better understand these present circumstances, and we are the leaders of the future. We are rising in positions of power in business and now in government, and it's incumbent upon us to not avoid that political arena the way that most of my most talented and capable peers are.
You're a Democrat.
Yes.
And I understand, you know, you recently went to a Bernie Sanders rally in the
mm-hmm.
Bay Area. You met the senator's wife, Jane. She's
yeah.
been in that very seat on the show, called him inspiration, that he had a vision. But in your launch video, you quote Hillary Clinton, who said, human rights are women's rights and women's rights are human rights. So, is it Hillary Clinton or Bernie Sanders? Who are you supporting?
I'm so proud to be a Democrat right now, where you have these ideas coming head to head, people putting forth actual policy, talking about the issues that matter, as opposed to the vitriol on the other side of the aisle. In my
so
opinion.
Which is it?
I'm inspired by Clinton. I respect her work, her intelligence and leadership on an array of issues, but the energy of Sanders right now that he is tapping into with my generation is unlike anything I've seen. And being there at that rally lit a fire inside of me.
The burn. Erin Schrode, good luck.
Thank you.
Good luck in California. Thanks for coming on.